Hello, I'm Dr. Annadale from Mount St. Mary's University in Emmitsburg, Maryland. The Memory Palace technique works because it is based on three key principles. In this video, I will review these principles and give an example using them to memorize a totally new set of facts. The first principle of the Memory Palace is spatial memory. You memorize a list of things by associating them with familiar locations. And this works for two reasons. First, because your brain is well adapted for remembering places and faces. Places in your home, places you see every day, are almost impossible to forget and make great memory hooks. Second, it works because your memory palace is a place you have positive emotions about. Don't use a place you associate with trauma or sorrow. It makes memorizing difficult and unpleasant. The emotional associations with your home make it easier to train your memory. The second principle is exaggeration. We can easily forget normal things, the same as usual breakfast, the traffic light that turns green, but against this ordinary background, exceptional things stand out. Chocolate cake for breakfast, traffic lights that are 10 feet high and bright purple. As you fill your memory palace with items, you exaggerate each of them in some way. This uses your brain's programming to remember the unusual and the weird to help you remember. The third principle is repetition. Because you live in your home, the memory palace locations are constantly in your experience. When you review the items you have filed there, you mentally walk through them again and again. With time, they can become as familiar to you as the locations you have pinned them to. Now, for my example, I have chosen a field I know nothing about. Chemistry. A little while ago, I did a DuckDuckGo search on nucleotides. I found out that there are five nucleotide bases: adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine, and uracil. I also learned that adenine and guanine are called purines, which have a double ring of 5 and 6 atoms, while the other three are called pyrimidines, which have a single ring of 6 atoms. I'm going to try to put all this information into my memory palace. The first 6 slots in my memory palace are keys rack, kitchen sink, freezer, sofa, and TV. Here are the exaggerated mental pictures I made up a few minutes ago to help me memorize. First, adenine, keys rack. As I hang up my keys, there is a sticky note on the hook and it says add a 9. Second, thymine, sink. Thymine is spelled like thy and mine, so I imagine a medieval knight standing at my kitchen sink, pointing to the drain, and saying, "Thy mine is there, sire." Third, guanine, the freezer. The beginning of the word, gua, reminds me of bat guano, and it ends in 9, so I think of 9 chunks of bat guano in an ice cube tray. Ugh. Fourth, cytosine, sofa. There's an old grizzled explorer telling stories on my sofa, and as I walk in, he's saying, "The sights I've seen." Fifth, uracil and the television. There's a home improvement show on, and a woman is yelling at a window she's building. She yells, "You're a sill, not a threshold." And for the final fact, adenine and guanine are purines with 5 and 6 atoms in a double ring, while thymine, cytosine, and uracil are pyrimidines with 6 atoms in a single ring. I noticed that adenine and guanine both end with 9, and 9 is more than 6, so they're the larger double ring bases. I remember that they're called purines by imagining that they think that they're better or purer than the other bases because they have more atoms. I remember the name pyrimidines by thinking of a single ring of 6 atoms as a pi. That's it for my review of Memory Palace principles and an example of their application. Thanks for watching today. Goodbye.